Hi, welcome to another installment of my Mass Effect multiplayer class guides. The coming of Diablo 3, we've had many defectors, one of them Lord Zakir himself, but I shall continue for the time being to play Mass Effect 3 as my multiplayer as my primary form of entertainment in computer games. So what we have here is a guide, my own personal guide to the Asari Justicar. A couple of things I want to note at the outset. One, I've included my incredibly inglorious and incredibly idiotic death. Considering I basically had the thing soloed, and I just wasn't paying attention, got flanked by a phantom and instant killed, I included that because I have a good sense of humor, and these things happen, unfortunately. The other thing is, the first three waves seem to have not been recorded by Fraps. I have no idea why. This shit happens way, way too often. For some reason, it never happens on my two-man runs, but whenever I try to solo something. But this was my first attempt to solo the Justicar. Now, I don't know if the build I'm presenting here is popular or not, or even if it exists, but I know it exists, but basically, I am not interested in biotic combos at all. I'm not interested in pairing up with other people and making things explode. That's not what this build is about. This build, I dub the Bulwark build. It's a Bulwark because, in my opinion, it's the most effective tank in the game, barring perhaps a Krogan Vanguard, which is kind of a different animal. So that I wouldn't really count that as a tank. But you get my drift. The whole point of this build, and I'm very fortunate with the objectives I got. I have a lot of objectives in instances where I can show how effective this build is. Bulwark build is essentially a tank build. Is to just make a really, really durable, damage-resistant Asari Justicar that makes liberal use of Reave, occasional use of pull, and use weapons to kill. Pretty simple at the end of the day. Other things you might see in this video are some of the very difficult things that a non-infiltrator has to do when soloing. Now, I'm probably quite known on the forums for my distaste for infiltrators, and even though it is a co-op game, I think a lot of class viability and power and what have you can be seen in solo runs. And what you see here, I think it's wave 6, the objectives with the disable devices. I'm forced to kite a lot, and you also see a very good instance of me using the protective bubble to save my ass, I think twice even. It's very effective, and I'll get to that in a second. But whereas an infiltrator there wouldn't have been able to kite around the map, he could have just cloaked the second before going to the objective, and he would have been fine. This is my point, that at the end of the day, an infiltrator, really, even the part where I got instant killed, I would have found it just there to be pretty unsafe in the middle of the map, giant map, as a non-infiltrator. But as an infiltrator, I probably just would have hung out there, then cloaked, and then moved on. The point is that infiltrators are overpowered, and the single reason for this is cloak. It allows them to finish any objective without any problems, particularly disable devices. Not only is the damage boost there, but if you're soloing as an infiltrator, you're pretty much almost guaranteed to be successful. It's just a question of patience. And no matter how powerful other classes might be, that's just not the case. You're always going to be visible, and you're always going to be drawing aggro. That's the difference. I don't understand why people don't get that. And the only counter argument I've heard is it's not a game designed for solo, it's a co-op game. But when people use that argument, as I've often heard, the problem I find with it is that the point I'm making is actually strengthened and supported by the fact that when you're playing as an infiltrator and you're playing with non-infiltrators, whether it's three or two or one even. The fact is that one guy who's not an infiltrator is drawing all the aggro and you're getting a free draw at shooting things. The point is, infiltrators don't draw the same level of aggro. And that has an effect on the the amount of enemies attacking you, your objectives, and just about everything else. I don't understand why people don't get that. So when I say it's OP, that's the main thing. Yes, you can add on the hunter for get infiltrators, the hunter mode, and so on and so forth, and all that, but I think this video demonstrates the problems that non-infiltrators have. You are forced, even with the bubble, you are forced to kind of around the map and lead enemies away to disable objective devices that you would not be forced to do if you were an infiltrator. It's just that simple. But yeah, I can understand people enjoying infiltrators and so on and so forth, but this just needs to be said, that even though it's a multiplayer game, the fact is that solo run infiltrators will always have an easier time, and they will also have an easier time playing team mode, because they don't draw the aggro. That's the main point, and that's the point of departure and the end point for it all, apart from all the massive damage. So, anyone who says playing infiltrator is not easy mode, I don't know what you're talking about. But I don't want to dwell on that point too much. The point of this is a guide. So, Asari Justicar, in my opinion, is a truly, truly awesome tank build, bulwark build, that can just take tons of punishment. Throughout the video, you see me putting up my bubble and just sitting there, getting hit by rockets. I totally ignore grenades, it just doesn't matter. The key to this build is bubble and leave, and a couple of other things, but mostly bubble and leave. So let me just go through the build first. A bubble is entirely spec'd defensively, for obvious reasons, because Bulwark is a tank. And so, for Evolution 4, you want to take the shield recharge improvement. For 5, you'll want to take... God, what's that evolution called? I think I forgot. You want to take... whatever 5 is, the top one. And for 6, you want to take the final evolution, for which is increased damage reduction. It's you get even more damage reduction for 5, and then you get even more damage reduction for evolution 6, and as well as shield recharge rate. Then for Reave, the point of this build is not to destroy barriers and armor, and this build has nothing to do with biotic combos apart from the occasional full Reave combo, which I do sometimes. So that's not really the issue here. The issue here is making Reave into a means to create a tank. So what you do is you're certainly going to go for the area Reave. It's just too useful at 3 meters. You know, the duration's great, but something to consider, I suppose. But the 3 meters is just... it's just fantastic. It affects so many enemies at once if they're bunched together. It's really hard to ignore. And because it's spammable, you know. So anyway, yeah, 4 go for an area effect. 5 go for increased damage resistance. You're probably not anyway. And 6, finally, 6 is the crucial point. This is not a Reaper or Biotic optimized build. It's a completely different build, so you want to go for maximum duration, damage, and damage resistance. At the end of the day, when you fit max out Reave, you'll have 40% damage resistance to Reave, not to mention more damage to general enemies. Atlases aren't really that huge of a deal. Phantoms get killed for Brawl pretty fast, and the barriers go down fast anyway. So that's not an issue. And finally, the passive, 3 points in pull. Passive, everything, 4 is duration and weight capacity, 5 is headshot. And I don't put anything in 6 because I want 3 points in full. Occasionally it's useful. But it's not obligatory by any means. And fitness max out the bottom row as usual. So, having done that, let's focus talk about bubble and Reave. Bubble is an incredible power, defensively at least, for me, for this build. Because the bubble alone will give you 25% increased shield recharge rate, or barrier recharge rate if it's a Justicar, along with 40% damage resistance. If you're reaving someone, you'll get another 40%, so that's a whopping 80% damage resistance. As well as including your passive from fitness, you'll have a 40% increased shield recharge barrier regeneration. And you see numerous times in the video that I'm just standing there, like I said, getting grenades tossed at me, getting shot at. I have enough time against Atlas's, hang out and cover, charge up the draw for a more powerful shot. So this build is extremely, extremely powerful. And in terms of its tankiness, Bulwark build. One thing, the bubble is much smaller, but it's perfectly fine for just the Justicar. In my experience, barring specific builds, leaning towards biotic combos and reapers, the most players just ignore it. I mean, they can't just afford to chase players around the map and put a bubble down in front of them. So it's used mostly for yourself. But it offers you incredible survivability. The increased shield recharge rate, as well as damage resistance, and Reave too, spec'd out for max damage resistance. And you see a couple of cases where I've died. There's one prominent case I'll succeed in the video where I had a middle of the map giant disable device, which are a total bitch for non-infiltrators, even if you beat them away. And the bubble saved me. I was able to take in all the damage and I was able to get out on time. So it's really that along with I'm running away and I'm still up on Eve, and that as well is very effective. The damage resistance is that's the key to this build. This build is a tank build. And let's face it, Reave is a very powerful ability. When you max it out for damage, it pushes barriers and armor, normal enemies go down very quickly. Reave has a 3-stack capacity, meaning you can stack it upon each other. Three Reaves can stack upon each other. And the nice thing about the Justicar is it has increased duration, and so your Reave will last somewhat longer. But no doubt, Reave is a very powerful ability. One thing that occurred to me when I was doing this, up until my ignominious death towards the end of the video, terrible, terrible, terrible. It's pretty embarrassing, but like I said, I have a sense of humor, so I'm including it. Is how much easier it is with any power than soloing with a Krogan soldier or something like that. It is. The difference is just astounding. Not infiltrator crew style, but it's certainly a lot easier to solo as opposed to a Krogan Sentinel or a Krogan Soldier, which I think are some of the toughest solo things to do. So you've seen a number of instances where I'm making excellent work of the bubble for protection, whether it's being stationary and using it. One thing I do, and this works much, much better on small maps. This is choke points. Entrances where a 3-meter bubble will cover everything. Corners cover. Glacier, for example, you have entire entrances that you can just cover with a bubble and you'll be quite well. So you get a lot of that in smaller maps. But even here, using the bubble and choke points and throwing it up, and like I said, you can, as long as enemies aren't coming at you, and of course, after wave 7, at wave 7 onwards, enemy count kicks up enormously, and so it's a bit difficult, but you can still use those choke points and just have the enemies come at you, take the damage, take the fire that they're throwing at you, and just kill them one by one. That's the strength of this build. The strength of this build is its survivability. It's, in my opinion, next to infiltrators cloaking and running away, and Krogan vanguards with their tankiness charging, and spam guards and what have you, that's certainly the most durable for other reasons. So that's what I enjoy about this build. And like I said, I have no interest in biotic combos or anything like that, apart from the occasional pull Reave. That is entirely optional. In fact, I could just as well recommend ignoring pull and just going for an extra 10% weapon damage, which is pretty nice as well. The weapon choice, I think, is up to you. I'd go for a lightish weapon. Draw 10, I have 130% cooldown, which is good enough. but if you take something, it'll give you 200%, you can spam it even more. But as many people on the forums know, I like the Gaul most. It has almost, it's just an all-purpose weapon. It does fantastic damage. It's great at long range, short range. It's great for everything. But I have tried the Talon out, and actually the Paladin is quite good as well. But the only problem is with Phantoms, if they get in close, you have no way to crowd control them. It's just impossible without, I mean, even if you get headshots, whatever. So, anyway, that's why I prefer the Grawl. That is my preferred weapon. Oops. Solo runs. And yeah, that's pretty much the build. Like I said, I think there's some good illustrations of how this build works in terms of its damage and resistance. But think about it, 40% stack, I don't know if it actually stacks, but it seems to. 40% plus other 40%. It's really, you're really just making the best out of Reave and the bubble. And you can be stationary for quite some while, and then go on to the next point, next choke point, and cast another bubble. So it's quite effective, this build. It's a lot of fun. I personally prefer this build to the biotic ones. Biotic combo ones with explosions, although that of course would be more effective if you're just fighting troopers or you have a specific purpose in mind. This is sort of all-purpose build designed around survivability and defense with a hefty dose of offense as well in the form of draw and use itself. Anyway, yeah, so. And you also see some of the difficulties encountered as a non-infiltrator when soloing. I think Wave 6 was a very good example of that, as well as the hacking objective. Like I said, the first three waves were, for some reason, not recorded properly. I got red X blanks. I have no idea. I apologize for that. So I didn't... It is gold, even though I don't think it actually says that from Wave 3 on, but there was no... Know that I play gold people will pretty much case people excuse me if that is happening at the time. And anything else to say? Yeah, that death scene at the end, totally ignominious, totally, it's just embarrassing. I think my first Justicar solo attempt, and I basically had it made, and what happened? I botched it. Vigilance is always required, and of course that's a good point to mention when you're soloing as a non-infiltrator, that because aggro is on you 100% of the time, you have to pay attention to what's going on. What happened to me is, I believe, although a lot of people will concede this, the most typical thing. It's not so much an issue soloing. The issue with soloing, apart from really non-impossible objectives, which occasionally happen, it's happened to me with my Krogan soldier and what have you, is lack of vigilance. Killing enemies is easy enough, depending on your situation and how you do it. But one thing that can happen when you're solo running is you get pinned down in a spot, and then there are too many enemies, and then you can't get out. So mobility is key, especially on a large map such as Giant. And vigilance, yeah. So for example, on this particular map, there's a ramp, that top part. It's very good for sniping, draw, or other weapons. You cast a bubble which covers the entire choke point. There's always a danger that if you're not paying attention, a phantom will climb up the ladder and stab you. In my inglorious and horrifically bad death at the end of the video, you'll see me... I thought I was clear. I thought I didn't have the phantoms in mind, how fast they were. In fact, I was thinking it must be in the middle of the map. And lo and behold, melee. I mean, if I had seen it coming, I would have cleared the phantom, no doubt, but that's the whole thing. Constant vigilance is required with particularly with servers, with phantoms. I think Geth soloing is probably by far the easiest. Reapers are maybe the toughest for other reasons, depending on how you... But let's not talk about the principles of soloing, it's simply the he needs vigilance is the most important thing. It's getting in flank that kills you, usually. Barring some objectives that are nigh impossible, and sometimes they are. Certain disabled device objectives are impossible for non-infiltrators. No matter how much damage resistance you have, how much protection, no matter how much you kite them around the map, it is just impossible. But anyway, so a little commentary on the principles of soloing. And for the record, I never published videos, so I didn't think they're very remarkable, but I've actually only come very close with other classes. So far, my record for soloing has only been with Infiltrator, Krogan Vanguard, and Asari Vanguard. I've come to wave 10 or with just about every other class. Usually I get a shitty objective, that's what happens. But today, I got a decent objective. I finally got a hacking objective for my first Asari Vanguard Justicar run. And I botched it later on, but it was stupid lack of attention on my part. But that's the point when you're soloing. And I do think, in contrast to a lot of people, that that soloing really defines a class. That's when you're going to find out what the strengths of the class are or not. So for example, the Justicar, in combination with other biotics, that's incredibly powerful. So is the Asari Adept and what have you. The thing about both Asari Adept and Vanguard is stasis. I mean, you take away stasis, it's a different story, but certainly with stasis, I have successfully soloed with a Asari Vanguard, and it's beyond easy. Apart from disabled device things and things of that nature, stasis, Grawl, headshot, it's almost instant death. It's ridiculously easy. That's an overpowered class as well, but not to the extent the Infiltrator is because of aggro. We always have to keep this in mind. If there's no aggro on you, that means you can shoot and shoot and kill things. If there is, then you're going to have to compromise and do something to get around that point. But it was nice to do my first little biotic guide. Like I said, for now the Krogans are coming. And I don't know, after such an ignominious and I have to say, this death is not very embarrassing. I can't say it's particularly powerful for me, but who knows, maybe there'll be another attempt at some point in the future, but there are enough points. My guides are not about demonstrating soloing skills so much as demonstrating how certain skills work. And sometimes it's a two-man run, sometimes it's a one-man run, whatever. This demonstrates those principles pretty well. Lots of good uses of the power of defensive bubble along with Reave damage resistance. Anyway, before I ramble on, thanks for watching, and I'll be posting this on the forums. And see you there. Hey!
Thank you. research data to a local network. Requisition a local server to upload data.
Understood. Let's move!
Upload underway. Stay close for faster connection. We need the upload ASAP.
Got it!
You're about halfway through. Maintain upload.
Acknowledged. Go time!